Hi, I'm Bill Snodgrass. Welcome to this episode, this tutorial on PortraitPro 18. We're going to look in this episode, we're going to look at the skin feature, the things that you can do to work on and improve skin. This is one of the photo editing things that I endorse fully 100% because people want to remember sort of the idealized version of themselves, not the version that has blemishes and that sort of thing. That said, you gotta be conscientious as the person becomes older, such as me. If you take all my wrinkles away, it's gonna look like somebody photoshopped that picture, which is what would have happened to get rid of all the wrinkles. But if you get rid of some of the wrinkles and some of the spots, you know, there's so many, it's just gonna improve my vision of myself. So balance, there's always balance in this editing process. All right, the picture that I've started with, I kind of foresee this going to Instagram. So I've already cropped it into a square using Photoshop, and now I'm gonna launch the plugin. I'm going to the filters, I'm going to the filters down to Anthropics Portrait Pro. Anthropics is the company that makes the Portrait Pro plugin. I'll put a link to their website down in the description. The first thing Portrait Pro is going to do is try to identify faces in the picture. It is also going to try to outline the features of the face and put them in control points around various parts. This picture is going to be a little more challenging for two reasons. One is the profile aspect. It's like a 45 degree. Plus, the model is wearing glasses. It's found the person and wants me to identify male or female. This picture came from a photo shoot session that my photography club did a couple weeks ago. And the photographers enlisted this guy to come and model for them. And this is one of the many pictures they came up with. All right, it has loaded the picture and put some control points in. Remember, you can zoom in by scrolling using the mouse wheel, the scroll wheel on this side, and then you can move the control points around. If you want to drag the picture, you drag on this side. If you click on this side, you're moving control points. As almost always, I feel like I need to adjust where the eyebrows are. Looks like it has nailed the eyes on this one. All right, once we have the control points set, once we have them where we feel like they're in the best place, we're ready to begin applying the different edits to the picture. I'm gonna turn off everything except skin smoothing, the one we're gonna look at in this tutorial. I'm gonna first of all begin with the touch-up brush. The touch-up brush, you can think of, if you're familiar with Photoshop, you can think of the healing brush. It's going to give you a brush and you can change the size and the strength of the effect. So if you want to just go in and spot remove a few of the major blemish areas, this would be the thing to do. Grab this brush and I always advocate kind of starting in the middle with the tools, the middle settings. In this case, they've defaulted it to 59 and a brush size of 14. Changing the brush size is one of those things that makes sense to do. Once you're done with the tool, and you can also paint with it, you can paint areas, then you can click it off and now the hand comes back and you can drag. So a first place to begin is with the touch-up tool. Now we'll go into the skin smoothing tool set. That was the brush. Go ahead and open a couple of these up and look at them sharpening. And I'm gonna sharpen this just a little bit. I feel like the photographer may have soft focused this one a little too much. If they were trying to do that, they may have just been misusing the camera. Trim eyebrows is a setting, and then texture is also a setting. That's gonna do skin texturing. I'm gonna go first up to around the eyes. Not gonna do a whole lot around the eyes because he is wearing glasses, but the Leiden eye bags, all of these will split out left and right. The eye bags, this is gonna be the area underneath the eye, and you can do a couple of things to them. One is you can lighten the color. A lot of people will have dark patches of skin underneath their eyes. And then crow's feet are gonna be the corners of the eyes, not a lot in this picture showing, but you can smooth out the lines that are on the corners of the eyes. Lighten eye bags. If you don't differentiate, the slider will work the others as a group. And you can begin to see on the image on this side, you can begin to see in this area right here, the effect of lighten eye bags. And the young man hasn't a lot of eye bags to lighten. Smoothing them, also an area of wrinkles, and we'll take that out just so we can see. This is operating on the skin a little further up, and it's trying to smooth these things out. Crow's feet, not really even showing in this picture because of the hair and the angle of the face, but that would do the same thing to the lines there. All right, around the eyes. Imperfections, this is skin in general, imperfections. So this is gonna be looking for blemishes and things like that. And it will work on those in order to clean things up. And it's gonna work in sort of a general overall thing. The more specific pimples, you may have to go in and deal with them with the brush. When you deal with the pimples using the brush, it's going to affect hairs and things like that. Pores, this is just generally going to smoothen out the skin. Fine shadows, again, this is taking away some of the contrast in the face in order to smooth and give a smoother appearance. Thin wrinkles, this is something someone a little older may benefit from, a touch on the thin wrinkles that will not completely remove them, but it will make them smaller and less prominent. And going back to the touch-up brush, bouncing back and forth between the two things. Trimming eyebrows is going to take pieces of the eyebrow that's outside the control point lines and sort of blend those into the skin. Left, right, around the mouth. These would be wrinkles around the mouth, the corners. And if you want to apply the features of this to neck and arms and other things that are exposed, that would be here. If you want to see where it is being treated, if you want to see the area that has been identified as skin, you can click the View Edit Skin Mask, and it's going to show you all of the areas that it thinks are skin. And if you want to add to that, you can use the brush to add skin. So if I wanted to identify this part, these parts of his body, now the way it's going to do is it is going to, within the outer circle, apply anything it finds that matches the inner circle. And so it has the detector size is the inner circle and the brush size is the outer circle. So it is detecting anything that is inside that inner circle and it is applying that to the outer circle. This will allow you to be able to go around the fingers and apply the skin mask to all of the skin very easily. The more detailed you want to be, obviously the smaller brush you're going to use. And that detector brush, if the applier brush goes beyond the skin but the color is different, it won't apply it. Now it picked up a little something there that was not skin, or maybe this is just the side of his finger. I think that's the side of his finger. So now I have added skin into the mask. The OK button to apply that. back to the face, view the skin, edit masking area, and it is nailed it here. It is very little that is not skin is missed. It differentiates between eyes and lips. And then there's a refine edges button, which will allow it to go in and reapply the logic to get to the finish piece. So the last of the features is the textures. And using the texture, we can change the way the skin looks and apply different textures. Also, we have the spot removal. So this is all part of the texture family of buttons. How much do you want the texture to show up? How little texture do you want the skin to have? All of these things. And then what type of texture do you want it to use? They're very, very subtle. So the skin texture types are very subtle, the differences between the different types. And it's adding that artificial texture, smooth with fine hairs, which would be sort of more of a natural, normal skin texture. Spot removal, this will go in and clear up different imperfections in the skin color. That is the skin tool in a nutshell. Getting the skin mask set is probably the most tedious part, and then it is just adjusting things to taste until you get it the way you want, using the touch-up tool to deal with imperfections, and then moving things around and getting the picture to represent what you want it to represent. So that gives you a pretty good picture of what you can do with the skin edit tool. Very, very easy to use, very clear what each of the different settings does, and makes taking a picture from okay to pretty awesome very simple, combined with the other tools in the suite of tools. You can do a very good edit very quickly and get really, really, really good results. Hopefully this was helpful. Hopefully you enjoyed seeing how this works. Please click the like button, subscribe to the channel, sign up for notifications. I do a lot of life lesson, motivational type videos. I do some other, sometimes not so serious videos. And then the occasional photography tutorial. If you're interested in those kinds of things, please, like I said, subscribe to the channel, sign up for notifications. That is all for this episode. I will see you in the next one.